Mwereri wa Farothi wa Thayo TV, good morning. Nida kena nego kora guko na yukia gaidishi ya kwa. Thino wa Farothi wa Thayo channel na TV eno hii tonea mawodo mode. Tuigira haa tulea ragia kiugo. Tuka hoyo teithio, tuka support ya do, tuka kanyo baya gai, tuka ya kama odo mode. Na hale haa kinja nego kumeli, tuka kumeli, hale haa kinja nego kuruta. Nekatho umenya mawodo, mawodo mashio mago kore. Kumenya kiugo nego teithagi ya mawodo, todo wado igio na notete makanithaini maingi maga kuheana tondu matiwe kuheana kutaithagi atia. I mean, kuri mundu utekaga undu tondu doi ni kwaguo ni gwiko doi benefit ya kuri ndu mataruta icunje cia 10 tondu matiwe fata wa icunje cia 10 matiwe moguni maria moka gafta kuheana gicunje kiu. No na moguni maria moka thutha gwa kanyumba ya Ngai na maundu maria mangi mothe na nikio ndu ingi matamekaga. No kugerera murutani maria turehaga haha ni matumite andu ingi magie na knowledge e kama hingura miturire ya wega cenjia na magaikara wega. Na mbere tugithiete na mbere na uthi hali ya kenda na urore button iyo ya subscribe kana ule wa mihinya akondu hinyete mihinyeti kuhana ready na nigeta tuhote kuthie na mbere rushini rwa muthe ndi na Reverend Charles Blessings tugithie na mbere na maundu maingi muno tukoe tutukeleria haha andu ingi ni matuikite ya kuguneka na andu ingi ni makuritwo kuma maundu ini matiganite. Reverend, karibu sana.
Thank you, God bless you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Yes,
welcome in the house of God.
Thank you.
How are we minister and we bless God's people.
Nigo nigo
ndake na muno ni gukuona na ngiya kurathime muno.
Asante.
Omothe nitugutethia andu a Ngai.
Nigo.
Na wabe nigucokia ngatho. Since we began to come to your channel, nigukoretwo na a lot of things happening. Andu makoretwo makirathimwo muno.
Yes.
Maundu mao magacenjia. Angitura hoya na uguku. Na we have seen the hand of God. Na no nyende kuga from date 26.
Yes.
27 and 28. That is next week. Friday.
Mweri uyu wa February.
Makiroko. Nginya hwaini. Saturday the same tuliki na Sunday. Na ndede tukwa kona seminar ya all churches.
Wow.
Goko guo, tukihoera adu. Na with my team of pastors, we are ready to do that work. Joke joke liye the team of pastors gado, goko na tukinyitanina na wega. Tutiagete pastor kuma 15 to 20, and they are faith people. Na tuwa utawira mwega nao.
Okay.
Tudhiete mishi mege kuma tuwa nanile.
Wow.
And God has blessed his people. Rumu the data day topic itago, when you realize that your destiny is at risk, what can you do? Ati ugitao kwa. Kana umenye mwerekera waku kana haria Ngai aigite ugakinya hari ugwatini ungikatia. Because many of us need to work to understand the power in our destiny and the many people who depend on us for healing, for restoration, for breakthrough, for deliverance. Ugako realize that your destiny is at risk. Realize ati Satani kulu dwa targetete destiny yako. On Sunday I was telling people where it is good to look at the battles you fight in your life. Na waloha baido iliolua gari. Olole kulea iku magereria. And I was telling them, when you realize that your destiny is at risk, there is something you can do. Na great people in our homes, great people in the churches, great people in the place of employment, great people in companies, ni makarago at risk of missing out their destiny, needed work waga ku understand, na gini kuhotelo katakati ka bala. Because one of the weapons the devil uses, ni frustration in the war, akahudhila gossip, akahudhila lies, na akahudhila rejection and stagnation, to make sure that you don't get where God wants. When I realized that my destiny is at risk, miaka nedhile, no makanida menyadila hujia, didi hata kuruga moria Ngai arenda. I realized that my destiny is at risk if I don't take a step. Now, today I want to help God's people. Ali of the mara tuona, okule wo the mari, erolia Farothi TV, wherever you are. Ni ufatie kurora motorile waku, na ni dole wakwa, no siyoge alore wake. Odia allies ati, when your destiny is at risk, something needs to be done. Kuri godadi yako hoya meshe denyiki, na agaho erado. No dadi alaise, these demons, they are the koi ni irado ya mono. Ne iradi deka. So I had to fight reinforcement. Ne dog gare ine di gari. Now you know that for me, we are able to fight all of us. We are able to fight all of us. Because one secret is this. For me to make into my destiny, I cannot make it alone. I need other people around me so that we may make it to our destiny. Now, if you read Judges 14:5-6, Samson met with a lion. And remember who was Samson? He was called to deliver Israel. No agicemanine muruthi farafara ini. But when he met with the lion, akirealize muturira wakwa wirira ini. So God released to him more power and he overpowered the lion because he realized, oh muruthi donaka kuniga ithero. Woka kumeria. When you realize that your destiny is at risk, you can do something extra rather than what you do. Now, if you go to the book of 1 Samuel 17:34-36, David fought with a beast when he was in the wilderness alone. Why was he fighting lion? Why was he fighting beast? Because he realized he was not living for himself. You are living for many people. You are living for many destinies. I'm happy when I see people come in church. They are jobless. God gives them a job. I'm happy to see when people come with the demons. God delivers them. I'm happy when we go to families. We see what God is doing. We praise his name. When you realize that your destiny is at risk, yani ukamenya hahogo tangu kule ndomakoto destiny yako shiria at risk. Ni urafeja vio wena moto ngai ni agwitete no hena maroho mokite makuhigireirie ugakora miaka no guthira thie maroho maya marehete risk muturaini waku. Because many of us, we don't realize ourselves. Tutikwenda ndomaka end up gukoro magithiuruka mataina mwerekera wa muturire. We need to understand that when the devil points your destiny, he not only points you, he points even those people around you. Na nikionaga thini wa mecie kuna ndo mataruaga bara na nikule ngimaruaga bara. Like now, if you look at the people who are not born again in our families, even their families are so much at peace because Satan ndo kidu marorania now. He has nothing he is asking from them. That is not in demand rare. But look at the people with a great calling. The higher the calling, the higher the battles. Already na mwito wa iguru ugu nogo bara siri ne. But when you realize the battles you fight, they are not to finish you. Me thank God because of the battles I fight. To a new level, and I made a decision because I know who you are. I am, and the anointing God has poured on me. Any battle that comes my way, be it a gossip, be it a riot, be it a sin, be it what, I have realized I carry a destiny for many people, and for that reason, I will not risk to joke with an enemy. There is one weapon called destiny, and when you know how to fight for it, you get far. Now, look at people who are with David in the cave, those guys who are in debt. They were in sickness. They were in conflict. They were hungry. But if you go to 2 Samuel 23:20, as you knew Adoria, Masoka, Guika, Maudu Manene, if we just read that first, if we just read that first, 2 Samuel 23:20, and Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, the son of valiant man of Kabzeel, who had done many acts, he slew two lion-like men of Moab. He went down also and slew a lion in the midst of a pit in time of snow. I had a dolema in Daudi. Haria cave of Adram. No lunima gendima ikarani na Daudi. Am magarurani matuka mighty men. Oyo akolide two lion-like men. Akiruano wake mahota. Akishoka akigira irima. Akikola mulothi hede as no. Na akiutoria. That one means for us to make it to our destiny. If you want God to change your situation, you must also change your position. If God will change any situation in our lives, we must change our position. If you want God to change anything that you are going through, you must change the level of friends you have been having. If the people you have been having do not pray, they do not know how to pray, pull them to a place of prayer. When you realize that your destiny is at risk, I remember there was one of my brother. I saw his life, how it's going. He is called Reverend Wilson. We are serving him together with him in church. I stood on his behalf and I decided this man will not be crushed by the devil. Why? Because I saw his destiny is at risk. Look at Samson. With a jawbone, he killed 1,000 men. Why? Because they were risking his destiny. Realize, mukiria gai yangu teide ori watini. One hand amadire maenda kuhu ikio watini. One hand amadumaenda kuhu ikio watini. One hand adumare mutorei no akumaenda kuhu ikio watini. One hand amatoho ho seitani alarehe. Tau seitani ya hoho taka matoho ho. Aga wakaka igire meza ine matoho mahanama. When you understand that your destiny is at risk, why has adegimagara ile maudu maigimu no nikina woko dhuda? Because devil kana seitani dedaga. Makinye kulea gaya daga. And so it is because of coming to yourself and realizing who you are and declaring, now I'm going to make an appointment with God and I'm going to fight for my destiny because it is at risk. If we realize who we are, mudu e menye na menye kiria ngai yareketi thini wake. You will not cry over one door when it is closed, because you realize there are seven more doors that are open. Many people have learned life from this nation because of the risk of their destinies. But you see, even where they went, Satan didn't know what to do. But we have one weapon, the weapon of prayer. Wherever you are, a man of prayer, despite the weed that will be brought to you, you always rise and overcome. Gutama kanye ruo ro kolaga mudu no ndi atiriri okay menya no okay realize no kamenya muturira wakwa wi hatari ni na wamenya wi hatari ni you take a next step.
All right,
it is upon realization of who you are, because the first thing you need to know, why does devil fight you? Mirudhi akolaga Daudi nikikaga gukora brothers yake, because they knew this man is a man carrying destiny. So brothers yake city na experience hard ya mirudhi guti hadu to iguaga abalo ile na mirudhi. But here he fought with a lion, he fought with a beast, he fought Goliath. Why was he fighting battles that other people were not fighting? Tad aria mari kuo mambo ikalie, but him, he had a destiny. Now look at Samson. When the lion came, he was able to understand this is a matter of destiny. He was able to fight. Look at Daniel in the den of lion, era takatini ka mirudhi kogo mirodhiro ni mekirie ni ngai, because his destiny is at risk. Look at the other people ale maikirio iri maruri ya mirodhi after Daniel was out. Matia kijaga thi because they had nothing to discuss with the lions. No way we na anointing when you are called by God. Look at Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. These guys are in fire, but they are dancing in fire. Why are they dancing in fire? Because their destiny was at risk. But they realized, even if we are in fire, nikole kitu tukuete extra gitali na adwali yangi. I want to encourage people who are suffering depression right now, those who are suffering stress, ona nyumirie adu more than are mara suffer a lot of issues in your life right now, because since corona servants of God have been suffering. But there's one thing you need to know. You need to connect with God of resources, the God of everything. When you realize that your destiny is at risk, where does your help come from? It comes from God. So many people, because of not understanding the power in their destiny, aige maria ini ni makiririo ni mushukani, aige maria hujia ni makiririo, aige maria doona ni business, aige maria na supermarket, adu maria na destiny si avata. But when the wind blew upon their lives, when shake up came, when the enemy came targeting their destiny, because guy da operate kana iguya, God always operates with men who are ready to stand. Many people right now are digo ko duthine digo ko matato ine thiuruka wone people who had a great destiny adu mari na mwerekera shaitani akenje kumanyemerea. When you see devil targeting you, akenje kuhigura kamurango kanini. When you see people attacking your destiny, when you see people attacking your calling, you don't need to stay there and argue with them. Raise your level of prayer, rise above opposition, rise above those who are attacking you. There is one thing I like about Andiko. Hale kanyo ndika kageta guomu. Gaka kari ya ganyama.
Deli.
Kakoko gaka kari ya ganyama. Geta guo ki. Gaka kakoko kari tai ya hoiti.
Oh, ok.
Olia geta guo. Kikukiri ya ganyama. Kikukiri kunyita igo. Kimiru maga na haki igo. Gikami habri na mugongo. Nona ya igo. Defa itaka na kikoko ki ulegi. What it does. Yombo kaka into higher altitudes. Ikobuka. Na dira fight na kigogo. Ikobuka. Ega kinya to a level ni akinya iguru muno kundu kuhehu. Na kyo kigogo giki tendu kimenyete ogukuthi kuria kiraria mahindi. Kuria kiraria nyama, kuria kirahengicana na ndu borerainde. Giakinya o level cido hoira dega kinyaga ri. Gika igwa guku ni ndaremo ni guikara. What does it do? Gikaremo ni kuhuhia. Gikarekia ego. Gikaharuka thita bomu. Gikagwa gigakua. The ego survives. Why? The work of an ego is to fly on the higher altitudes. When you realize the way you are supposed to fight. Aria makunyitire na uchawi na uganga na tumaundu tungi. Tiga gutindoke busy na. Upgrade your level of prayer. Change your ways of fighting the battles. Fly high. Fly into a higher altitude that even if they are attaching themselves on your destiny, there is a praise they are going to get, and they are going to lose you. If you read 1 Corinthians 15:32, Paul says, I fought with a beast at Ephesus. To test your faith. And so when the beast is released, it is what you believe and the faith that you have. And Paul says, when that beast was released, he was able to fight with a beast. any great man who is called of God does not fight low levels.
So it is what you believe,
yes,
plus faith versus opposition.
Because many of us ukaje kuopozwa kwa nyumo cie ugoka opposition ukaopozwa kanitha ini ugakora ndo ingire ni mathire na makirekia mwito because they feared the type of battles that came on their way because the amount of goma niere kagiriria bara kuligana na destiny ya mundu ukarekirio bara ni ukaliga go everybody is rising against you.
True.
Not because people know what they are doing but malaho macho ni mamba harukite to oppose you not to get what you want. Look at any great man of God, anybody who rose to his purpose, they fought oppositions, they fought demons, they fought animals, they fought with the beasts until they made it. And that's why the people who bring more war on our way, I don't fight back because I know my weapons. I will fly high in the mountain. I will stick in the mountain day and night. I will release prayers. I will release missiles. Because when I realize my destiny is at risk, something must be done. Now, when you realize that, look at Joseph. When he was in the pit, evidence that this man has died. His destiny was at risk. But look at what was in him. On a lady, families depended on him. His brothers were to depend on him. Tomorrow they will need him for bread. The people who oppose you, they have no clue of how your tomorrow will be. The people who fight you, they have no single revelation of what God will do with you tomorrow. And when he was delivered out of the pit, he met himself in the house of Potiphar. Again, his destiny was at risk. Again, he realized he is at risk. No mutimio shida tigiro na guo. Any evidence. Agetimo na kuwa moko. Ati Joseph neko daga kumurepu. Aikio jera. He was still at risk. No risk is your other noga yuatu agakashira. Gako mutua modo. Wherever you are, and you find that there are situations that are opposing you, there are forces that are opposing you, threats of death, threats of suicide, rejection, lack of documentation. You see that you don't live the life that you want to live because there are forces that are opposing you. When you realize that your destiny is at risk, you can do something extra. Fight as you have never fought. Declare war on the enemy. Make a decision. My life must turn. Samson, when he realized that Dalimaido, Nalimwaje, he prayed one prayer to God. And the guy, I just make one prayer to you. That is the only prayer we need to make on our life. That since my God, my children, my root, you are the 12 jewelry, guy to a kuhoya, all the time, we to have ability and power to get new anointing and we shake the kingdom. When he prayed that, he was given an extra power to redeem his destiny from the risk he was in. And akiuria kimona kia liku hekalo ini. Nyonia kia kia hekalo. Nigeza hota kodhi gidhia. Na hota kumira. When he was shown that pillar, akimomola hekalo, he did more than what he could have done when he had eyes. Why? Because there is a power to finish strong. Dera gado, if you know you are above 35 years, and I repeat this, niyodha akita mufira wakula odiabere. Mato humo the nuko yotona mula odiabere. Bala siyo the nuko leto na siyo. Bugele liyo siyo the. Gutida mauduma atoho. Nuko yotona mula humiake yodhirete. But now, no atura la odiaku yabere. 35 years are gone. Waikala miaka 35 uge kate. What have you achieved? What have you gained? Where are you? Niki you got decade up to where you are. Now, kule ni gimu mayiro miaka. Before they get to 35, the devil has stolen their ears. He has managed to kill many destinies. Nuri, ona mufiri wadha kakura odigiri. Matuku mamudu ni miaka 73. So, akoni hito kiti 35. Otiketie miaka 37, 38. Okolo wadha kama mufiri wadha ogidhaka. So, agikoni hito kiti miaka 35. Don't put your destiny at risk. Ehelera mauduma atoho. Ehelera adisoshi atoho. Don't listen to people who build nothing in your life. Don't waste your time on gossipers. Don't waste your time on jokers. Don't waste your time. Don't play games with the devil. It is time to redeem out your destiny because you realize it is at risk and something extra needs to be done. Because they didn't realize there is a weapon that has been fired on their destiny to put them at risk. In one level. But when you realize who you are, You need to avoid these simple games. And it is time we make a decision. Redemption on our destiny. Once and for all. One realize who you are. That is enough. Samson realized. They are not playing games with me. I need to destroy them.
True.
David, when he needed water, he was so thirsty that he needed water. Actually, no good the hell am I. Five men told him, we are going to risk. Tell my man in the camp of the enemy. And they needed to go there and get that water and come back with it.
Yes.
But the guys risked and they went and got water. Because his destiny was at risk. When you realize who you are, and this is the word, come to yourself. Understand who you are. Stop simple battles. Tika na tuudu tulindi. Ajekuruwa balas ya kukura destiny. Balas ya kukura maudu. Balas ya kukura. And remember the time I went home.
Yes.
I told my brothers, this type of life you are staying, that we cannot stay together. Because when when they agreed that you are going to fight as one, that home is going far. We speak one language. Why? I told them, miakera tuenayo. We don't have time. It is you to realize yourself. He never went to joke with the lion. He went to kill it. All the people who realized. Now look at the Joseph at the pit. Look at Esau and his brother. He is joking. And yet he didn't know whatever he was giving was at risk. Genesis 27:40 was told, the time you shall realize who you are and you become less stressed, you shall take over. It is high time we realize that after Corona now, there is a revival that is coming in our nation. After Corona, there's a breakthrough. Because we don't depend on people to do great things. When there's COVID, why are we building that? Because when the weed is growing, go against the weed. When you see the weeds in your home, stand yourself and fight the weed. Focus on the change. I thank God for my ambition. Because anytime there's a weed that is blowing against the ministry, I go to him. I tell him, affirm your calling. Affirm your anointing in my life. I tell you, even if you try to fight, you are fighting the wrong man. Why? Because there's another authority that is speak on top. When it speaks, I speak to those who are under me. And we are able to move on. Why? Because we realize goma tisho ya wamudu. Tuthakake pokanake. Tuthakanagie nake aha. Atuonake todu tulago kola. Like now there's a devil that is risking the life of Kenyans. It is risking the life of people in East Africa. It is risking the life of people in Africa and in the whole world. It is called the demon of cancer. We play games with the cancer. It is destroying so many people. And right now, as I'm talking, I know there are people going through those they call the chemotherapy. I know there are people who are suffering breast cancer, cervical cancer, prostate cancer, pancreas cancer, brain cancer, so many cancer, lung cancer. But we need to stand against this demon and tell cancer you have no place in our nation.
Never.
Corona came, Ebola came, and it left us standing.
Yes.
Even cancer, don't come to risk our destiny.
Yes.
Don't come to risk our life. We must take a step and speak against this because it is a lion that we need to kill. Any man of God who went far, look at Samson. But enemies have come. Amenya destiny yake ndio what ini. Akasomoka na higo otuko. Why? Because there's an extra power that is needed when you realize your destiny is at risk. I'm speaking to a person who has given up. I'm speaking to a person who is making up his mind that this year, if my station does not change, I'll commit suicide. I'm speaking to a person who has experienced magic nyoba. I'm speaking to a person who has fight witchcraft. I'm speaking to a person who will fight rejection. I'm speaking to a person who is fighting failures. Do not give up on what you are hearing. Focus on your God. Because when you realize who you are, it doesn't matter how much demons are going to hurt you. Couldn't make your spies in their place of work. Okay, you know, spies wherever you go. Okay, you know, spies in hotels. Okay, you know, spies in hospital. Okay, couldn't make your spies. Because their destinies are at risk. But reason. Anybody who was at risk of his destiny and realized the call of God in their life, you will be able to stand and overcome. When you realize that somebody is threatening your life, you'll be able to stand and overcome. This morning, I release the spirit of a warrior over each and every one of us who is viewing us there. I know you are down, you are discouraged. You are feeling you are coming to an end. There is a level you get that even the men of God around you don't understand the battles you are fighting. That's the level you need God himself. You rescue your destiny from the risk and from the attack the devil has brought on your way. I know great people, but because of fear, of something they did, because of torment, because of attacks, they are giving up. I want to give them examples from Genesis. Abraham fought until he won. Samson fought. He fought with the lion. He fought with the Philistines. He won. David fought. Joshua fought. Moses fought. Servants of God have been fighting. We are not the first people. People have been fighting. But they never lost their faith. No situation. What can separate us with the love of God? Is it lack? No. Is it suffering? No. Are there beatings? No. Are there frustrations? No. Are there marriages? No. What can separate us? We need to realize the power we carry in our destiny. True. And when we realize that, we are going to defeat the lions. Amen.
Amen.
Wow. God bless you.
Wow. What a word. Gwiciria kiu nikiugoge gukorwo ngikiariria ngoro cia andu aingi tondu ndika ni urarikirie kumenya andu aria matuthikagiriria haha. We even have most senior people matuthikagiriria haha. Destiny ciao ni ciaringirwo aini anene wonaga umuthi uyu ni wa maiguaga na andu maiguaga maundu maya nimo maguo ni gukorwo magitaguko nigetha mamenye yes ni kuhanikirwo ni kuhanikire. But do I sit there and watch? I have to move.
You have to move.
Ni hamu ndu ngukira na mbiririe kumuvu ni undu wa tabarire ino. So we thank God for you. Na maybe before to no no jedwa bihyane na bayaku joke to gitanire horwegi haha tuikarite na tuko tukieririria ka tuko tugikira video cito haha ginya utigirire tuona kundu guku ne kwa hingu guothe ginya hedi atukona rutura huthira matawa.
Amen. Theini wale twa Jesus. Amen. Na bayaku ali muli +254 726 946 100 through 726 946 100 tukira plus tadwa ali amena kuja goko niko tukoletwo and we thank God for that. Na next week twina seminar iraji ya Friday, Saturday and Sunday,
dates
26, 27 and 28.
Okay.
We are inviting people from every place. Iriaja githa idato cia kiroko igathitha mugwanja tuka break for lunch tukacoka thai nyanya thai nyanya ni deliverance. Deliverance tugaka tukahoya tugaka redemption for 2 days nigetha tune ngai agikura andu ake koguo o haria hothe uri wina andu meguku maybe wina kou. Invite people, let them come and we serve God together.
Okay.
And you know it will be great.
Wow.
Amen.
March 14th.
March 14 we have a father drive. Ya kulikia kanitha yo hawo tigareti. We forget fundraising. Na leme ku nono wede ukora hamo na ithwe. You are still welcome. Ni ni daga donor dimiti. Donor ifati gamene gai wa hela. We don't sell salt. We don't sell anointing oil. We tell God atulathime. Na mudu agende tumuhoere. We tell you to come with your own anointing oil.
Okay.
That we don't want to compromise the word.
Wow.
Tweda ku walk in the streets. Kulia tu wanagua, kana kulia duma anagua. Tutikuenda kugua, ulia magua magimana. We want to preach the word the way it is.
Okay.
Yes.
Very good. Niyuka na adhimu niyukuro ratulore kana hea do maiketie. Nikata tumasho kalia gado. Dutha ga video kaletwa kwa tuweka just dagika hetoku. Dagika shigano na hetoku. Tulore keu maiketie. Nikata tumara dhimidhie na keo. Na magidhie na bere na weka guwa. Nikata tuhota kwa kanyo beno ya ngai. Irekirire. Hawe tiga ndo ipati ria hari amu kinyetie nguo nguo wiro ri ukoretwo ri murito no koro finishing ni tuitika undu kahutho. We thank God ni hari amu kinyete
o ndagika icio woka kwa ndu mwathani ateithia. We have Backson Jogona 500 twina Backson Jogona twina Dan Murithi nekia 1000 twina Jane Mwangi 500 twina Joyce Muriuki 1000 twina Nelius Kamau 500 koguo ni makoro ma manage kuri ni tokotwa manage kuri zo almost at like 10000.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow.
Just within a short time.
Wow. Yeah. That's good.
God is faithful.
Barathi mumo no. Mundu rio gukuona video no. Nitoheana na bashia thimo. Ni juine guyaga video kanini korea kanithe hana. Nigetha ngagekira ha muisho. Nigetha mundu wothe ukuona video no. Ona kia ngenda gutweka kirathimo na kuruta ihigari yake ria kenyumbeno ya Ngai. Ona ima murimo haha ni handu aliukaga. Ni handu ageta mucie.
Ni
noke ahoere Ngai ho.
Amen.
So we thank God for that.
God bless you so much.
Kuregeria hau. God bless you na March 14. Netoa kwa tuwe live kule Facebook na YouTube. Mudo kerorera ihigari yake dakana liganero. No shio ni muda. Kwa wei Kenya, please, oka. To support mwakoyo. To support mnyubeno ya Ngai. Netoa kete shito igadhira. Tuwa kete shito tuka ekira maudomega. Tuka shigemia. Ya Ngai tuka tike hano ugu. Nituleru. Oka imudo deke ya kuwa nayo. Demo hairadhimu.
Amen.
Thank you.
God bless you.
All right.
Mikate tano, samaki wawili, hesabu ngumu. Kwa wanafunzi, wake Bwana Yesu, ili walemea. Bwana Yesu, alirahisisha, akawalisha. Nguvu za mujiza, zinafanya kazi, Bwana waweza. Bethania uliwapata wamomboleza ndugu Lazaro eti amekufa ulimuita kutoka kaburini.